I'm going to present the following paper, which is teaching finite element method software in formal and non-formal environment with MOX. This work has been carried out with the help of the university funding in terms of doing the MOOC and doing the research itself. Okay. The problem that we found is that we need to teach the finite element method, which is a complex method in engineering, probably, or in our case, in the master level. Usually teaches with the traditional methodology, in the best cases with the hands-on activities. But there's a clear necessity that we found that the students need to be more and more involved with this kind of software, which is probably the most common ones, are ANSYS or LSDyna or Abacus, when the student goes to the company. Okay, we need to provide these students with more knowledge about these softwares in order to go to a company and develop their skills in order to be more more suited for a company contract. Okay, we can identify the formal learning, which is the classical one that we use without at the university. The non-formal learning, probably related with the MOOCs, is the first idea that we get. And the informal learning, which is the one that we can obtain in different platforms in our free time, for example, with Google Plus, as some colleagues mentioned before, YouTube, or other kind of platforms, okay? Our objective is, during the semester that we taught in the master level, this subject, this finite element subject, we developed the MOOC at the same time. So we offer the students to, okay, as we have that MOOC, please join the MOOC, and as we are teaching in the class this knowledge, please do it the MOOC. The MOOC is based on LSDyna, the software that we have at the University of Polytechnic of Madrid, and the students join the MOOC and do it at the same time. The main goal, so, is to quantify the grades in the formal learning affected by the MOOC, and to analyze the students' feeling through a questionnaire. Okay, as I mentioned, we need to help the University of Polytechnic of Madrid for the funding. We developed the MOOC in Milianas. So we started at 2nd of April and finished at the 20th of May. The enrolled student was high, was 1,400, but only 100 finished classical in MOOC. So we have a 22% of dropout rate, which is quite high. The MOOC is divided in 6-7 modules, which is the introduction, and finally to the most complex one, which is the terms of explosive in LSDyna. The videos are 15 minutes. We only have a test to check the knowledge of the student. We don't use peer-to-peer activities because they are complex, and in this case it's quite complex because we need to receive the model from the student and run the model, check all the things, which is crazy for 100 students. So that we do here is for the 16-17 course we only have the formal learning, and the 17-18 course we include the MOOC to these students. So we compare the results in both consecutive years. What we have is a 14 hours course, 20 hours dedicated to the theoretical part, and 20 hours dedicated to LSDyna. In the second year, we include the option to make the MOOC to the students, so they have more time involved with the program if they want to do the MOOC. In terms of the MOOC results, as I mentioned, the dropout rate is high. In terms of the results, in both cases, in both courses, we saw that based on the human Whitney test, the mean value or the median value of the both courses is different. So the course with the MOOC, the grades in the course that they use the MOOC is really high in compared with the previous year. So they really hands with this. So probably because we have more time to active methodologies in the class, and the students paid attention to the theoretical concepts through the video, so they can watch it and watch it and watch it. And they have tests on so in the MOOC, so they can check if they understand something or not. They came to the class and asked something about the MOOC. In terms of the questionnaire, we saw that usefulness of forum to answer questions, the people with the MOOC found that it's useful. The number of practical cases, they found that it's enough in compared with the other one that they haven't got the mock. They found that the number of cases is good enough. And the course reading, they found that it's really low in compared with the other, which found that it's really high because they have more work. They don't find that they work more, but they work more because they have the mock on the free time. So the student performed better with the mock technology. The student satisfaction with the face-to-face classes is better through the mock extra time. And the problem is that we only have 6 students 1 year and 6 students the other year. So the results are in some way limited. Okay? And the results are based for our specific context. Okay? And thank you to my co-authors and the Universidad Politécnica.